Hey, this is just a really bare bones video showing you how to use Vertex Colors in Blender to make texturing in Substance Painter a lot easier and faster. Okay, the first step is to bring your model into Blender and get a sense of where you want different textures. Think about where one texture will end and one will begin. Next step is to download Text Tools. This isn't a required add-on to use Vertex Colors, but it's free and will save you a lot of time. You can find Text Tools on GitHub. Just click code and download zip file. Leave the zip file as it is. From there, go to Blender, Edit, Preferences, Add-ons, Install. Find the zip file that you downloaded and click OK. And from there, just go to Add-ons and enable the add-on. Pull a horizontal screen out and change the view to UV Editor. Press N or click the side arrow and find Text Tools. Click the Color ID tab and change the mode from Material to Vertex Color. Okay, let's go back to our model. This is a technical tutorial, so I'm not going to go over best shading practices, but it's typically most efficient to have what you're texturing be one object. You can join your model together however it's most prudent by pressing Ctrl J. From here, go to Edit Mode in your viewport window and make sure you're on Polygon Selection Mode. Select every polygon that will be the same vertex color, and then go over to Text Tools and assign one of these colors. If you need more colors, you can always add more up here. Once you have your vertex colors assigned how you want, switch to Object Mode, select your object, and click File, Export FBX. In the dialog box, make sure you click Export Selected Objects, and click OK. Time to open Substance Painter. When the program is open, click File, New, select your file. Decide what resolution settings you want. I'm assuming you unwrapped your model correctly, so we won't go over that. And click OK. The next step is to bake our texture maps, including our vertex colors. Go to Texture Settings and scroll down until you get to Mesh Maps. Click Bake Mesh Maps. The only selection that is required for this tutorial is ID. Click the drop-down for Color Source and select Vertex Color. When that's selected, click Bake Selected Textures, and let's move on to the next step. Now it's time to add some texture. For this example, I'm going to add a plastic material to the buckle first. I'll find the material I want for it and add it to the model. Problem is, of course, that I added it to the whole model. So what I'll do is go to Layers, click on the material I just added, click on the Mask dropdown, and click Add Mask with Color Selection. Click on the mask that was just added, select Color Selection, and go down to the Color Selection. Click the eyedropper that says Pick Color, and select the color that represents the buckle. From there, you can texture your entire model with this method using filters, materials, fill colors, etc. As you can see, it makes texturing super fast and simple, and once you add some good lighting, it looks even better. Hope this helps. If it did, please consider liking and subscribing, and tell me in the comments what other tutorials would be helpful. Not an expert, but would like to help where I can. Thanks.